أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم آية نمبر 89 سورة البقرة ولما جاءهم كتاب من عند الله ومن end and لما mean when جاءهم came to them كتاب a book which is Quran من عند الله from Allah مصدق which confirmed testify verify لما that book معهم which is with them which is Taurat a book came to them which verify which verify the subject, the mazameen of that book which is with them, which means Quran confirm what is in Taurat. وَكَانُوا and they were مِنْ قَبْلُ before يَسْتَفْتِحُونَ asking victory عَلَى الَّذِينَ against those kafaru who were kafir, mean mushrik. فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ so when came to them مَا what عَرَفُوا they recognized kafaru bihi So they denied it. فَلَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ So the curse of Allah should be on the disbeliever. So before the arrival of the Quran and the coming of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when the Ahl Kitab, the people of the book, had any encounter, like fighting with the mushrikeen, So when they will be asked, they will ask dua that oh Allah, through the barakah of the Prophet which is about to appear, the last Prophet, Khatamun Nabiyyin, give us victory. Like they were so much in intizar, in wait for the new Prophet to come. And when he came to them, and he was from the children of Ismail, not Ishaq, so they become jealous, and because of that, arrogance and jealousy, they denied him. So they, Allah is referring to that. وَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ when came to them كِتَابٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ a book from Allah, which is Quran. The book came to who? To the children of Israel, Quran. مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَهُمْ which testifies the subject matter of that book which was already with them, which means Taurat. وَكَانُوا and they were مِنْ قَبْلُ before يَسْتَفْتِحُونَ فَتْحٌ mean victory and استفتاح mean asking for victory asking for help against who? عَلَى الَّذِينَ against those كَفَرُوا who are kafir which mean mushrik فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ so when came to them مَا عَرَفُوا what they recognized كَفَرُوا بِهِ so they denied him فَلَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ So the curse of Allah should be on the disbeliever. So the Prophet ﷺ, he was recognized by the mushrikeen, by the Jewish people and the Christian people. And why? Because the Prophet mentioned is in the Taurat on regular basis. Like for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَإِنَّهُ لَفِي ذُبُرِ الْأَوَّلِينَ This prophet mentioned is in the scripture of the previous people. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, الَّذِينَ يَجِدُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِنْدَهُمْ فِي التَّوْرَاتِ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّي Those who follow the ummi, the unlettered prophet, which one? يَجِدُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِنْدَهُمْ which they find written with them في التوراة والإنجيل. Similarly in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the Sahaba of the Prophet وسلم, and then at the end he says, ذَلِكَ مَثَلُهُمْ فِي التَّوْرَاتِ This is the way I describe the Sahaba of the Prophet Muhammad وسلم in Taurat also. So you will be surprised that in spite of the thousands and thousands of tahrifat, alterations and changes in these books, This is also one of the miracles of the Prophet that until the day of judgment in this current Taurat, And this current Injil, you will find that the mention of the Prophet ﷺ is there, and very clearly. So to just to refresh your iman and my iman, one of the Basharat which is in Torah, I describe a little bit in detail, so that it will come on record. Because what happened, that if there is a good Basharat in Torah, so they keep on changing it in the translation. Like for example, 100 years ago, that what translations and what commentaries are available, they change it. And how they change it, I'm going to discuss, okay, here in the next few minutes, and you pay attention to it. There is a chapter in Torah, in the Old Testament, that in the Old Testament, in Torah, there are more than 30 scriptures. And out of more than 30 scriptures, only 5 or 6, they are related to Musa alayhi salam. Okay, that they are written by Musa alayhi salam. The rest are written by the students later on. So one of those, so that is with the heart of the Torah, because they refer that this is by Musa alayhi salam, and the other are by his students. So one of those chapters is Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy in Arabic means istisna. And istisna means the second command. Okay, this is from like isnain. Okay, istisna is not like exception. Istisna means second command, the second law. So in that chapter, Deuteronomy, which is istisna, the second command, there is verse 33.2. According to that, to the Bible, Musa alayhi salam said this verse 7 days before his death. And I also tell you the Arabic Bible, because in Arabic, and because the English is very old, and the Arabic is not very old. Surprisingly, the language of the Bible is also, the Arabic is good and it can be understood. So regarding that verse number 33.2, the Arabic Bible say, وَهَذِهِ هِيَ الْبَرَكَةِ. This is that barakah, blessing, allati baraka biha Musa rajulullah bani Israel qabla mawtihi. That 7 days before his death, Musa alayhi salam, he said this to Bani Israel, this verse. What the verse say? In English it said, the Lord came from Sina, like the mountain of Sina. In Arabic it says, Ja al-Rabbu min Sina. And the second verse say after it, wa ashraqa lahum min sa'ir. Ashraqa means like shining. Okay, so the King James Version translate wa ashraqa lahum min sa'ir, and dawned. Dawn is like the daybreak, when the light come. So dawned on them from seer, S-E-I-R. In Arabic it say wa ashraqa lahum min sa'ir. What is sa'ir? Okay, like Lord came from Sina. Okay, so Sina, you know, the mountain of Sina, Tur. What is Sa'ir? Sha'ir is the second name of Jabal al-Khalil. There is a city in Palestine that the name is al-Khalil. Around al-Khalil, there are mountains, and that mountains are called Sha'ir, which is 20 miles janub, south of al-Quds, al-Sharif. Okay, and this is referred to the Nuzul of Isa alayhi salam. And the first one, that Lord came from Sina, it referred to the Nuzul of Musa alayhi salam. So the mountain of Sina is referring to who? Musa alayhi salam. And the mountain of Sha'ir is referring to who? Isa alayhi salam. And then the verse say, وَتَلَأْلَأَ مِنْ فَارَانِ. Okay, three mountains in Torah. One is what? Sina, and the second is Sha'ir, and the third is Faran. وَتَلَأْلَأَ مِنْ Faran. تَلَأْلَأَ is also like shine. Okay, and it say, and he shone from the mountain of Faran. What is Faran? Faran is the mountain which is in Mecca. You already know Mecca. So in the Quran there is a pattern that these three big prophets are mentioned. Like for example, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَالتِّينِ وَالزَّيْتُونِ وَتُورِ سِينِينَ وهذا البلد الأمين. So Tin and Zaytun are more in that area of Palestine where Isa alayhi salam was born. Fig and olive. So Tin and Zaytun refer to who? To Isa alayhi salam. وطور سينين refer to who? To Musa alayhi salam. وهذا البلد الأمين مكة refer to who? To Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the same pattern is this Basharat in today's Taurat. That Lord came from Sina and then he shined and Sha'ir and watala'la min Faran. Okay, tala'la bright. Okay, shine. Okay, tala'la min Faran in today's Bible. Now they say, the commentator of Bible, they say, this is very clear regarding Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, because in Mecca, whenever you say Mecca, who come in your mind? And the Lord tala'la min Faran, what should we do with it? So they say, this Faran is another name of Al-Qudus al-Sharif, the commentator of Bible say. So then they say, but Isa alayhi salam is already mentioned that he came from Sha'ir, so why Allah is mentioning him again? And how famous is the name Faran for Al-Qudus al-Sharif? Like for example, you say there is Melbourne in Australia. So there is a Melbourne here in Florida also, but who cares about this Melbourne? This is only small. Whenever somebody says Melbourne is Australia. So there might be Faran in Bangladesh also, but you will say the Faran of Bangladesh or Pakistan it is. Faran in the whole world is where? It is Mecca. So our scholars, they are also very smart. They say, let's look at what Faran means in the Bible itself to prove it from the Bible. Because if we say Faran is Mecca, they're not going to listen. So there is another chapter in Bible which is called Genesis. In that Genesis, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about Ismail alayhi salam in Taurat. So he say in Genesis 22.21, okay, it say, Taurat say, وَكَانَ اللَّهُ مَعَ الْغُلَامِ فَكَبَرَ. And God was with that boy and he grew. وَسَكَنَ فِي الْبَرِّيَّةِ وَكَانَ يَنْمُ رَامِ قَوْسِ. And he dwelt in the wilderness and became an archer. وَسَكَنَ فِي بَرِّيَّةِ فَارَان. This is Taurat say. And he lived in the area, in the mountains of Faran. وَأَخَذَتْ لَهُ أُمُّهُ زَوْجًا مِنْ أَرْضِ مِصْرِ. And his mother brought for him wife from Egypt. Who is this? Ismail alayhi salam. So regarding Ismail alayhi salam, Taurat is saying, وَسَكَنَ فِي بَرِّيَّةِ فَارَان, that he was living in Faran. So Bible is saying that Faran mean what? Mecca. Right? Now the Tahrifat, one of the Arabic translator who translated Bible in 1851, his name was Arquitan. So his translation of Arabic Bible say, أَسْكَنَ فِي بَرِّيَّةِ فَارَان, and in the bracket say Al-Hijaz. It say what? Al-Hijaz. وَأَخَذَتْ لَهُ أُمُّهُ إِمْرَأَةً مِنْ أَرْضِ مِصْرِ. Right? So, this proves that this is Sina, Sha'ir, and Faran. When Islam was predicted to Najashi, the king of Abyssinia, what he say? إِنَّ هَذَا وَالَّذِي جَاءَ بِهِ مُوسَى لَيَخْرُجُ مِنْ مِشْكَاتٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. When he heard ayat of the Quran, so Najashi immediately say, it looked like this is coming from the same lamp. Because it sound very familiar what was given to Musa alayhi salam. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, when he do the tafsir of Surah At-Tin wa Zaytun, so he also say that ba'ath Allah hadhihi mahalun thalathatun. These are three locations, Ibn Kathir say. بعث الله في كل واحد منها نبيا مرسلا من أولو العظم أصحاب شرائع الكبار. In all these three locations, big prophets which were the صاحب, big sharia. فأول محل التين والزيتون وهي بيت المقدس التي بعث الله فيها عيسى بن مريم. تين and زيتون, olive and fig, ابن كثير say it refer to بيت المقدس and عيسى عليه السلام. والثاني تور سينين وهو تور سيناء الذي كلم الله عليها موسى ابن عمران. Okay, Sinin. والثالث مكة وهو البلد الأمين الذي من دخله كان آمنا وهو الذي أرسل فيه محمدا. ابن كثير thing. And then he say وفي آخر التوراة, because we said that it was 7 days before the death of موسى عليه السلام, ذكر هذه الأماكن الثلاثة جاء الله من طور سيناء, يعني الذي كلم الله عليه موسى ابن عمران وأشرق من سعير يعني بيت المقدس واستعلن من جبل فاران يعني جبال مكة التي أرسل الله منها محمدا. دين ابن كثير رحمه الله say that the best of these three prophets is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So he, Allah should have mentioned Muhammad first and then Musa and then Isa عليه السلام. Why Allah mentioned, you know, the other order? So he said, فَذَكَرَهُمْ عَلَى التَّرْتِيبِ الْوُجُودِي. Allah mentioned them in the order in which they were existing in Torah. Right? Because first is who? Musa عليه السلام. Right? So, وَلِهَذَا أَقْسَمَ بِالْأَشْرَفِ ثُمَّ الْأَشْرَفِ مِنْهُ ثُمَّ بِالْأَشْرَفِ مِنْهُمَا. Right? So, then we continue with this Basharat in the Torah. Then it say, after that, in Deuteronomy it say, and he came with 10,000 of saints. When he was coming to Faran, so how many people were with him? 10,000. Okay? So they said 10,000. When Mecca was conquered, the Sahaba were how many? They were 10,000. So there was a big trouble that how should we do tahrif in this? So in Arabic, in one of the translation, they say, وَأَتَى مِنْ رَبَوَاتِ الْقُدُسِ, that he came from the mountains of Qudus. Instead of the 10,000, they say, our scholars say, رَبَوَاتَ. Let's see what Rabawat mean in the encyclopedia of the Bible. That what Rabawat say. Rabawat mean 10,000 or Rabawat mean mountain in Bible. So Qamus al-Kitab al-Maqdis Muqaddas Dairat al-Ma'arif al-Kitabiyya al-Masihiyya. It say Rabwatun fata'ni ashratu alaf wa jamuha Rabawat. The translation, the dictionary of Bible in Arabic say Rabwa mean 10,000. And that is why the most famous translation of Bible today is which one? King James. Okay? And it say that he came with 10,000. So if you go and you look for this verse, it will also say that he came with 10,000 people. So this is, this fit like, okay, then we go in the Bible, it say, وَعَنْ يَمِينِهِ نَارُ شَرِيعَةٍ لَهُمْ. When he was coming, this prophet, from his right hand went a fiery law for them. Okay, which means the law was very strong. So, in the Quran, Allah said what? أَشِدَّاءُ عَلَى الْكُفَّارِ. Okay, strong law. And he, رُحَمَاءُ بَيْنَهُمْ, this Torah say, فَأَحَبَّ الشَّعَبُ. And he loved his people. Okay? So, Ashidda'u ala al-kuffar, what? Fiery law. Okay? And Ruhama'u bainahum, what say? Loved his people. Okay? And then, Tarahum rukka'an sujjadan yabtaguna fadlam min Allahi wa ridwana. So, Tawrat say, he sat down at your feet, everyone shall receive of your word. Wahum jalithuna inda qadamika yataqabbaluna min aqwalika. This is very much similar to Tawrat and Surah Al-Fatiha. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end say, ذَلِكَ مَثَلُهُمْ فِي التَّوْرَاتِ. This is the way I describe them in the Tawrat also. Right? So I summarize it for you because normally we are scared of this research kind of thing. But this is very useful because the ulama say there are more than 20 basharat in today's Bible. This is the most confirmed one. That this cannot be denied. Okay? And what is the summary? That Lord came from Sina. He shined on Sha'ir and watala'a min Faran. Faran is Mecca. These are three prophets in that order. And Faran, how Faran is Mecca? Because Bible say that Ismail alayhi salam, he raised up where? In Faran. So that means, and then he said that wa'ata min rabawat al-Qudus. He came with 10,000 of the pious people, which is who? Which is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right? Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.